Hey guys, I'm Jerusha and you're watching Jerusha Couture TV
2021.
Happy New Year to all of my subbies and followers and everyone out there watching. I hope that this year, fingers crossed, is a better all-round year. I hope that this year is, you know, a lot more progressive and, you know, less hurdles. Today I am here for my best and worst purchases of 2020. You know, in these videos, they're never the worst. It's just, I guess, a topic. But first, like before, there is still doubt that I am giving this baby away. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen a lot of these posts, but we are circulating and sharing. But at 200,000 followers on Instagram, I am giving away this Louis Vuitton Nano Speedy. I'm giving it away to you guys. I really am. I don't use it. I don't reach for it. And I'm sure it will be better with one of you guys. Share, tell your friends, because I am giving this guy away, one of the hardest sought after Louis Vuitton bags to get your hands on. Okay, so this does have to move quite quickly. I am going to try not to babble in between each item, but it does. Okay, because 2020 was a year of, let's just say, planet lockdown, and all we could really do was shop. Okay, I'm just speaking for all of us because I know it's true, all right? Logistics still went on, so FedEx, DHL, everyone could still deliver. So what did we do? Shop. Ding! Case and point. Ta-da! I was gonna move this to be all like YouTube professional, but dang, girl. I'm gonna go one of each just to keep it, you know, positive and bright. Starting with the best purchase of 2020. The fact that I could achieve this was astronomical, and it is right here on my wrist. We'll give you a nice close-up. I'll do a cutaway, but it is the Cartier 18 karat yellow gold Juste un Clou, just a nail, and it was momentous. I got it on my birthday. I actually got it on my birthday. Shops were open and everything back then. Now we're back in lockdown. This is a massive, massive achievement. So switching lanes, we'll go worst. It's difficult because I wanna kind of do it categories. So, you know, all the bags, I guess, and then all the accessories. This would be next. Wow, is it a shocker? I don't think this should be a shocker that it's kind of a worst purchase. Nothing's a worst purchase. It's so hard to say worst when we're talking about luxury, like how stuck up. The lesser of my best purchases of 2020. This bag is an amazing size, okay? It is a really great competitor for the Speedy B 25, which is above me. I had retired it and I wanted something with the black coated leather trim versus Rochette, and the same kind of size and access, so a top zipper. For the price point of this bag, which does have leather gussets and microfiber lining, I feel they have priced it wrong. You know, it's a little too steep. All right, it's hard to swallow. I think it's up around 3,800 Australian dollars now. It's too high for what it is. Yes, it's jazzy with all the gold. I think the layout is not great. There is a slip pocket here that gets in the way. But for what you get in this bag, I don't think it justifies the price tag. I really don't. This is in my best. You know why? And I've seen a few of these videos. Shout out to all my girls that have done these best and worst, or just top items of 2020. Or the best of 2020, you know, there's many going around. We were in lockdown for so long, obviously, and we've come in and out of lockdown and there's been restrictions. No one wants to take all, you know, their beautiful Chanel jumbos out and things like that. So to have a quick run around, which is exactly what this is the Louis Vuitton double zip pouch in reverse, monogram on one side and regular classic monogram on the other. Comes with its coated black leather strap, has a card holder inside. This is not a review. I've been hooking my multi-pochette round little purse and putting my mask inside that. It's been super, super cute. I made a reel of it on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram, I love reels. So obviously it's like TikTok on Instagram. Instagram low-key stole TikTok. And Snapchat, just saying. But this was definitely on the best purchase list. The worst purchase list is not going to be in my hands, okay, guys? This isn't a what I sold and why, because I feel like this year it's not really like what I sold and why, because I kept and used it. But the first off on the worst list that I did buy and then actually sold is the Spring Street. A few of you saw that it wasn't behind me. The Spring Street I raved about. I really raved about it. It shook me for the price. However, I am going to say for my lifestyle, and I know none of these for lifestyle. Some are purchases and, you know, investments, and they'll just sit there like the Pearl Chanel, but I wanted to use the Spring Street. It wasn't getting the love. It just wasn't. Then COVID hit and it just... Patent leather was not the vibe of COVID-19, okay? It was not the vibe. Canvas was for me, so I wanted to put the money into something else. I'll just quickly go over it. I have said this before. I unboxed the Palm Springs PM with reverse pocket. It was a nightmare of an unboxing. You've seen it, I've mentioned it before. Shocking. Returned because it was not 100% perfect, and that is why you should return. But it was absolutely smushed. That's on the worst list. Have not pressed the button to buy it back again since then, because the price tag to me at the moment is hard to swallow. Next up, I'm on the roll of worst that got returned. Neo Noe. It was completely crooked. It is not that I did not love that bag. I did. I didn't get a chance to use it. I showed it to you guys. I had even bought organizers from Smorga for it. I literally packaged it back up, called my SAMer and was like, this Neo Noe is completely twisted. Like the actual canvas, the way that they've cut it is twisted. Okay, best purchase. I feel like everyone had this on their best purchase list when I was watching back the videos from like the other girls in the live. And then also like shout out to Tiffany. Hi, Tiffany. Tiffany D. She got this for Christmas. I think her hubby bought it for her. We call it the small in the luxury community. Small, medium, large, but it's actually medium, large, maxi. This one is in the shiny kind of goat skin, the newer goat skin model that came out this year with the multiple color hardware, which you all know. This size is just so wearable. I cannot tell you how many times I have reached for this bag. It's got great access. Obviously, it's a flat bag. It's lightweight. This is not like a jumbo. This is lightweight. It's smooshy. It's pliable. Some people don't like how fussy it is, but it grows on you. I promise you, it grows on you. This will be interesting. I unboxed this last video. This is brand spanking new. Look at it. I put my things in it. I did a reel on Instagram. Ding! So I did a reel on it showing what it fits. It's amazing. It does fit a lot. It's something about it being a top handle and just a proper bag shape. What I'm saying is that the medium, small, or the small with the larger handle would work better for me. Okay? It would work better on my frame and it would work better in size wise. Sorry about that, just had to take a break. My neighbor decided to weed whack his lawn. Where are we up to? Sorry, I know, it's fast. It is really, really fast. Okay, a few more that aren't here. Alma BB in Dammy Arabian. You guys saw me unbox that. I was super excited to try an Alma BB. I really was. The Alma BB in Dammy Arabian has changed. Shout out to all my subbies and followers who are like, yes, Jerusha, you are correct. You are not just dreaming. So the coated brown leather went from being shiny, a smooth kind of texture, shiny and smooth, to a rubbery kind of finish. I actually thought I was losing my mind. A lot of you confirmed that I wasn't, and that in fact it was like the remodel of it with this like rubbery, guys, it was bad. I could see peeling, I could see almost that kind of glazing melting vibe. I was not into it. The best purchase of 2020, and it was right before the pandemic started. I had been in Melbourne right before it hit and I purchased this from the Collins Street Boutique. It is the Louis Vuitton Neverfull in classic monogram in the MM size. These aren't cheap anymore, okay? They're expensive. This, everyone's like, starter bag, but I'm like, girl, this, it is not cheap. Truthfully, if you're thinking about it, if I can convince you of anything, it's truthfully, this bag is brilliant. Moving over to a worst purchased list. I know. I know, I can't believe it. I had big dreams for this bag, really big dreams. Actually, let's put my handle from Smorga on it. I know you guys are dying for me to review these Smorga bag chains, and I'm definitely gonna do it. This is one of the best ways I like to use this Odeon if I do use it, which right now I don't. As a crossbody bag, this is your essential crossbody bag. When I unboxed it, I said that as well. Do not expect anything from it but crossbody. This bag came on my worst list simply because of this coated leather trim on it. This coated leather trim is not like how I rave about, you know, the black trim like of the Palace or whatever. This is like the Mikasa line. So the, you know, the black trim on the Keepalls, that Mikasa line. It scratches very, very easily. Like very easily. And when it scores, it almost scores gray. I started worrying. And the second you start worrying, it's not really like babying. It's being like, you don't enjoy it. Sticking with worst. This is sad because it came from Rue Cambon in Paris. I'm sure you saw that unboxing. My beautiful personal shopper Irene, the front row Paris. And it is the matching Chanel 19 zip O-zip card holder to match my handbag. It is on my worst list because this zipper, again, all they have to do, these luxury houses, is change one thing, one zipper, one clasp, one, you know, leather finish, one button, snap closure, and it can just throw the whole thing off. I remember when I looked at the Boy O-zip card holder and the zipper on that is plastic. I was just like, get your life, girl. I am not paying that kind of money for a plastic zipper. The actual teeth are chintzy, okay? It feels cheap. Okay, next up. This is the last one I forgot to talk about that isn't here. The Monserie PM backpack in black contrast. I purchased that for, like, as a birthday bag as well. I told you in that haul, I kind of yelled at you, but I said that this most probably was being returned, and it did get returned. To go and sell my Chanel Urban Spirit backpack, which has a flap and then drawstring, and then go and look at getting the Monserie, it just was like, why are you repeating mistakes, you know? The Monserie got returned. It is a beautiful bag. It is offered in the raw cow hide, in the Vachette trim, and it is offered in black. Obviously, I went for the black. It is beautiful. I am happy to say that completes our worst list. Again, nothing is worse. How ridiculous, nothing is worse. Okay, let's continue with best. Number one, hands down, let's move into SLGs. Get your life. How did this come back around? When I started YouTube, okay, when I started to get a mini pochette, which I did, damn every bin, these, you know, were everywhere. Everywhere, all over YouTube, everywhere, everyone could get them, la 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 la. These SLGs, key holders, card cases, the clay are the hardest items to get. And I don't think it's production. That's not what I think it is. I think it's a mixture of influencers saying, you know, great starter pieces and things like that. But I also think it's a ramp up in per wear cost versus, you know, if you have a spare $500 and your birthday's coming up, you can purchase this. Feel like that sort of ramped up over the years. So these guys are literally so hard to get, which is nuts because it is a classic Louis Vuitton piece. It is the Louis Vuitton mini pochette in all over classic monogram, and I'm in love, I'm besotted. Can't you just feel the vibe? It's a good vibe, it's a good vibe. It is good energy now. We are on the best list only, people. This is so gorgeous. I think the reinterpretation of this flat card holder using reverse monogram canvas was genius. Reverse monogram canvas, I'm gonna say, for Nicola's design team was genius. I don't really prefer him as the creative director only because I'm a total Marc Jacobs diehard fan. And now Virgil, I think they are just, it is parallel. But credit where credit is due, the reverse monogram, which grew on me. At first, I was a little scared. I was like, what are they doing to my life? Monogram is all I know. What are they doing? But when this little guy came out, it was hot off the press. For Louis Vuitton, this is my only flat card holder now. And for mini bags, flat card holders are genius. Best purchases list. Hands down. This could sit on my shelf forever and I could never use it and be happy. The aesthetics, layout, and design of this handbag is perfection. It really, really is. And even though there are definitely cons about this bag, you know, access issues, I don't use the ornate strap, I take it off and use my reverse monogram strap. Even though it has those kind of issues, it still makes you happy in the core of your soul. It is just one of those kind of wow bags. On to another kind of hard to get. Randomly hard to get item that I picked up this year due to one of my subbies and followers, a luxury fangirl. Hi babe. She notified me that this was back on the site available. I was so shook. I think I told you the babies were in the bath and I like ran to the computer and like purchased it. I was watching the kids, okay. I was watching the kids, also shopping online, but I was watching the kids. This does not leave my side. Honestly, I don't know what it is. I told you I don't know what I'm gonna do with my six ring, but I don't know what it is about the four ring. It is just such, I mean, yes, it doesn't hold a card. The six ring is the width of a credit card. But the way this feels in the hand, it fits in every single small little compartment bag that I have. Okay, let's wrap this up. It was not meant to all be luxury handbags and luxury small leather goods. Beauty products to show you. First up has to be, and this was purchased in 2020 because it is my third bottle. It's definitely stocked in Sephora. You can get it on Cult Beauty and things like that. I'm shaking it. Why am I shaking it? This is my By Terry Cellar Rose Brightening Serum. This has been a lifesaver because when you're in lockdown or you're only just doing your errands or you're running to drop your kids at daycare and run back and that's all you're allowed to do, putting this with a, like sometimes I add my moisturizer, but putting this makes you alive. It makes you alive. I first saw this on Lyd's channel. Hi Lydia. And she raves about By Terry. I think she even blogged for By Terry. She was like the face of By Terry. And I was like, oh yeah, I'm sure it's okay. I got it in the darkest sunny flash because she kind of said to, and I was like, this is gonna be way too dark for me. But I was like, she's pretty fair, I'm fair. And it worked. Lyd, genius. This is so amazing. And lastly, for beauty on my best list, which needs to be repurchased, because there is nothing inside of it. Dior Addict. The Dior Addict, and this is the Eau de Parfum, so it's not, so it's like the, I think it comes in another color, but this has pink liquid. I will link it below, I'll throw a picture up here. It has pink liquid, there isn't any. I wanted a summer fragrance or an all year fragrance that I could load on, and I mean disgustingly load on, and just not, you know, feel like I'm gonna sneeze, feel like somebody else is being totally wrapped in my scent, which is what Angel does. I am a complete Terry Mugler Angel fanatic. I drink it, I eat it, I have since I was 16. But it's an intense, heavy fragrance. I still wear it all the time, but I just wanted a light fragrance. This worked well, as you can see. I am repurchasing. I would throw this on the best list. It is right there. This is one of my last unboxings too. My amazing Game On from Louis Vuitton, Never Full in the MM, Game On in white. However, I have not used it. I have not touched it. I have not taken it out of the pigeonhole. It has just been sitting there. I stare at it. I oogle over it. So I'm not gonna pop it on the best right this second, but this I am popping on the best. Get out of town. All of you, many of you DM'd me, emailed me. How'd you get it? What the heck? How did that happen? Honestly, this bag has caused a tsunami in the luxury world, in the Louis Vuitton collector, you know, monogram lovers world, and I have been inundated on how to get one, where you can find them, how not to pay, you know, personal shopper fees, that kind of stuff. The answer is, my friend, every man to himself, okay? Titanic, the ship is sinking. You've got to find it your way through your essays. Personal shoppers, if they whack a, you know, premium on it, or if they whack a fee on it, it is still worth it. This is the most hot ticket item of the year, 110%. If it was my call, which it is on my channel, this is the hot ticket item of the year, 2020. This Louis Vuitton sac, you guys taught me, sac cur. The Louis Vuitton heart bag in all over monogram canvas knocked it out of the park. It is sensational. Okay, we're down to last two. Oh my God, I don't know how long this is gonna be. It's crazy. Okay, how can we not? How can we not? This is the Louis Vuitton Recto Verso, and it is nothing but genius. All the ways that you can use this, I used it since I got it, all the way through to pretty much 2 months ago, and changed out of it just because I was like, I'm gonna damage it. I won't stop using it, but it is definitely on the best list for sure. Okay, let's bring it home, people, before my neighbor comes back around with his weed whacker. This is my last item on my best list. Ding! That is simply because I could not believe I was able to get this back in my life. I had regretted the first time I ever got the Palm Springs mini backpack from Louis Vuitton. This was the style I got in reverse, all over, reverse monogram with the classic pocket. I did an unboxing of it. It freaked me out, not gonna lie. The reverse monogram freaked me out. I was like, what are they doing? What am I doing? Why did I get it in a reverse monogram? This doesn't make any sense. This is not who I am. So I went and I exchanged it for the PM size. It is a long story, my friends. I'm pretty sure you know it if you follow my channel. Being a mama too, I have been actually wearing them as backpacks and hooking it with the hook trick where you just do one and it sits higher on your back. It's much more comfortable. It's so easy to access, and that is definitely on the best list. So my beautiful friends and subbies, thank you so much for taking the time to watch this best and worst of 2020 purchases. Again, I want to say, please go ahead and follow me on Instagram. Tell your friends to follow me. It is true, I am giving it away at 200,000 follows. I know there's been doubt. It's like, oh, this was spam. Someone wrote to me and said, this is complete spam. You influencers work with companies that give you these things to give them away. No, get your life, girl. That is not it. Please go ahead and follow me, and this will be given away at 200,000 followers. If you enjoyed this video, guys, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already and you wish to do so, go ahead and smash that subscribe button below. I would super appreciate it, guys. I hope everybody has a great start to 2021. Let's get through this. We are in it together, and please stay safe. All my love. Take care. Peace.